cubano que soy. Y la música ha sido un elemento...
Cuban that I am, music is a part of my blood. And the inspiration for my songs comes from my work to promote seed and crop diversity and to promote diversity of thought.
Cuban agronomist Humberto Rios Labrada has helped to change agrarian practices in Cuba. Like farming systems in many countries during the last half of the 20th century, Cuban agriculture was highly mechanized and dependent on pesticides. In response to declines in biodiversity and crop yields, the Goldman Laureate opened learning centers and seed farms. Food production increased dramatically. The program now engages 50,000 farmers nationwide.
My dream is that one day all scientific research institutions will make seed diversity accessible and will recognize rural farmers' knowledge, and that Cuba will definitively become an organic agricultural island.
Rios has expanded his work in Mexico, where he set up farmer-led projects. Environmental lawyer Tuli Makama is the Goldman Laureate from the African continent. She's defending the right of people in Swaziland to live near private game reserves, where they've subsisted for generations.
When one gets up in the morning and they don't have any money in their pockets, they look to the environment to give them their meal for the day.
A 1997 law gave game rangers in Swaziland the right to use armed force against suspected poachers. Makaba says the policy has led to 100 deaths.
When you say to me you are killing poachers and you're actually killing people who are poor, neighboring the park, who are going in there to find things to survive on, I think it does not solve the problem. The lasting solution would be in terms of balancing the interests of the local communities and those of the parks.
In 2009, Makama won a landmark case. It mandated that non-governmental groups like the one she runs get a seat and a voice on the Swaziland Environment Authority Board, the highest decision-making body in the country. The complex balance between nature and human needs is also an issue in Poland's Rasputa Valley, which winds through vast tracts of primeval forest, peat bogs, and wetlands. It's one of Europe's last undisturbed wild areas. Goldman Prize winner Małgorzata Gorska has led the fight to stop a controversial highway project from cutting a swath through the wilderness.
The Polish government had already approved the highway, so we were afraid we might not succeed. However, we felt strongly that we had to try, because the place was so unique and so vulnerable, and because we felt that we were right.
Gorska, a conservationist with a Polish nonprofit organization, took the case to the European Commission. She hoped that Poland would be held in violation of the European Union's regulations on protected sites.
When we heard that we won the case in European court, we were extremely happy, because this meant that laws pertaining to nature were now considered to be as important as any other issues. It wasn't a private victory. It was a victory for everyone, not just environmental organizations, but for common citizens that simply love nature.
Other Goldman Laureates this year were honored for their efforts to protect Asian elephants in Cambodia, to expose pollution from factory farms in the United States, and to campaign for a ban on the international trade in shark fins. 139 people from 79 countries have received the Goldman Environmental Prize since it was established in 1989. Roseanne Skirbel, VOA News, Washington.
Un mundo más verde, con más sonrisa y menos contaminación.